In this video, we're going to be graphing lines using the slope and the y-intercept. So recall that we have a special form of a line, y equals mx plus b. Now in that form, which is called slope-intercept form, so this is called slope-intercept form, recall that the m is the slope and the b is the y-intercept. Now the y-intercept is where the line crosses the y-axis. So we're going to see how knowing the slope and the y-intercept helps us graph a line. So let's go ahead and do that now. Let's say that we wanted to graph how about negative 2x plus y is equal to negative 3. Okay, so the first thing I notice is that with slope-intercept form, the y has been isolated. So that's the first thing we have to do here, is get the y by itself. And I'm going to do that by adding 2x to both sides. And so I've got now, let's see, y is equal to, well, I've got 2x, but then still minus 3. And if I compare this now to my slope-intercept form, I can see that my m is 2. So let's write that down. The slope, the m, is 2. Do you see what the y-intercept is? Well, the y-intercept is the number, in this case, negative 3. So plus b, I can view this as plus negative 3, so I see that my b is equal to negative 3. Okay, so we often write the slope, the m, as a fraction. So I like to write this as 2 over 1, because what we do is we regard the 2 as the rise, and we regard the 1 as what's called the run. Okay, so what we do is we start with the point that we have. We have the y-intercept. Now recall that the y-intercept is actually a point on the line. So let's go ahead and draw a coordinate system here. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. Okay, so the y-intercept, that is the point right here. It's where the line crosses the y-axis. Okay, so now we've made use of this information. What do we do about the slope? Now, I like to think of the slope as a set of instructions, and it's telling you from the y-intercept what to do. So from the y-intercept, which is here, the slope says rise 2 and run 1. So it's important that you start from a point that's already on the line, in this case the y-intercept. So from here we're going to rise 2. Now rise refers to movement along the y-axis. So if the rise is positive, that means we go up 2. So I go up 2 and also I run 1. Now run is for the x-axis. So if I run 1, a positive 1, that means I go 1 to the right. So from here, I'm gonna rise 2, and I'm going to run 1. I rise 2, and I run 1, and that puts me here. Do you see how I regarded the slope as a set of instructions? It told me what to do from the y-intercept. And what that gave me was a second point on the line. And now that I have two points on the line, I can graph my line through those two points. And that's how we graph a line using the y-intercept and the slope. Let's go ahead and take a more complicated example. Okay, let's say we wanted to graph okay, how about we have 2x plus 3y is equal to positive 6. Okay, just like in the previous example, The first thing you have to do is isolate your y so that we put the line into slope-intercept form. So I'm going to subtract 2x from both sides. And on the left-hand side, I have 3y. And on the right-hand side, I have, well, negative 2x plus 6. Notice how I write the term containing x first, because slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b. Now we're going to divide both sides by 3. Okay, as we've done before, because this is a sum, you can split up the numerator and write both terms over 3. So I've got negative 2x over 3 plus 6 over 3. Okay, so at this stage, we like to write the x broken off. So I like to write it like this. Negative 2 over 3 times x plus, and I know 6 over 3 is equal to 2. And the reason I did that is it makes it easier to identify my slope and my y-intercept. So remember, the slope, m, is what you're multiplying x by. So m in this case I can see is equal to, well, negative 2 over 3, and b I can see is equal to positive 2. Now we have to make a decision here about what to do with the negative. It turns out that this negative you can either write as, you can write it with the 2, so I can write negative 2 over 3, or I can put the negative with a 3 and write 2 over negative 3. When we graph lines, what I'm going to mainly do is I'm going to put the negative with the numerator, so that I like to always leave my denominator positive, and that's going to help us in applications a little bit down the road. So I'm going to take the negative, and I'm going to put that negative with the 2, and so I get negative 2 over 3. And the reason it was important to make a decision is because, well, the numerator and denominator refer to the rise and the run. So I can see here that my rise is actually negative. So my rise is negative 2, and my run is positive 3. And my y-intercept is 2. Okay, let's go ahead and use all this information to graph our line now. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay. So if I then look at my y-intercept, so that's what we do. We first plot the y-intercept first, because that's a point on our line. So the y-intercept is 2. That means the line crosses the y-axis at positive 2, which is right there. And then remember, the slope is a set of instructions, and it's telling you what to do from the y-intercept. It says rise negative 2 and run 3. Now remember, rise refers to movement along the y-axis. And if the rise is negative, that really means fall 2. So we're going to drop 2, and run is movement along the x-axis. And because it's positive, we go to the right. So here's the plan. From the y-intercept, we're going to drop 2 and go to the right 3. Ready? So from here, we drop 2, 1, 2, and I also move 3 to the right. 1, 2, 3. And once I've performed that set of instructions, I get a second point, which is right there. And then I draw the line through those two points, and that's my line. And that's how you graph a line using the slope and the y-intercept.